Greetings, human beings. How are you today? I hope you are well in every aspect of your life. Let's clear up the energy around. Today, we are going to be talking about this upcoming new moon in Cancer. July the 9th at 6:16 p.m. for me here in Pacific West Coast time. That will be at 9:16 p.m. in the East Coast of U.S. So if you want to do moon magic like I do, make sure you know your time zone. So we all know, again, new moons are all about planting your seeds, planting intentions, our dreams, our hopes to come. That's what new moons is all about. New beginnings. It's a new cycle. It's a vortex opening. It's a portal, as every new moon, full moon, eclipses, they're all opening vortexes, as well as the winter and summer solstice are also portals. So there's a big communication and downloads of new information from higher planes. There's upgrades happening that are being sent from above, electromagnetic waves that, if you are receptive to them, it will upgrade our way of thinking. It's like upgrading your iPhone. It just works better, more clear, faster. So on this day, there will be a new moon, and a beautiful new moon in the sign of Cancer. Both the moon and the sun will be together in the sign of Cancer at 18 degrees. Cancer is the fourth house in astrology, first water sign of all the zodiacs. So for me, Cancer being the first water sign tells me that it's a more of a motherly, feminine energy compared to Scorpio and Pisces water signs. The fourth house, the number four in numerology, means the foundation, the four pillars, the home base, the house, the family, our mother, our relationship, direct relationship with our real mother or adopted mother or mother figures in our life, women we see as teachers, as mentors. Is this motherly, nurturing energy that is sensitive, comforting, like that mother that holds you when you're just desperately crying over a heartache or some tribulation you might have encountered, and that mother hugging is very comforting. That's the energy of Cancer. The element is water, and it's a feminine energy. So it's sensitive, it's intuitive, very intuitive as well. And on a flip side, can become very dark and deceiving, because the moon represents intuition and also represents the negative energy, because this feminine energy is negative energy. Nothing bad about it. It simply is what it is. The unknown, the mysterious, the tapping into psychic abilities, into the psychic world. Very witchy. Without going into all the other aspects within the actual chart, I just want to emphasize just on the energy of Cancer itself, wherever it is in your chart, whatever is happening overall around with other aspects. This beautiful new moon, what it calls is for us to tap into our own inner world, inner emotions. Cancer is connected to the heart, to the Anahata chakra, love. To tap into our own deepest of emotions, because Cancer requires the feeling, the emotions in the body, a sexual energy as well, as water connects to the sacral chakra, which is the sexual chakra or energy center in the subtle body. So to tap into that emotion and that love we have for ourselves and see where we are at, allow yourself to feel whatever needs to come up and be released. So to tap into those waters of your inner world so that you're able to open up your third eye and see that the Cancer energy is naturally psychic. And then from there, see how you feel about your environment. Maybe in some other cases is the environment that we're at. Are we happy? Are we feeling good? Remember, this is about feeling. Are we feeling good where we live with the people around us? Do we feel safe? Does it feel comforting? Or do we feel fear that we can't be ourselves, so you can't sleep at night because you don't feel safe? Cancer is about safety. Being safe in the home and having comfort. Do you feel that in your life? Do you not? If you do, are you content? Remember, Cancer represents also the mother. And even the children, yourself as a mother, if you are a mother, as I am a mother, it's time to reflect with your children, the relationships that you have with them, how you view yourself as a mother, how you think others view yourself as a mother. Or if you don't have children, then how nurturing you are with your pets, maybe with your plants around you. Remember that if you have living plants or you have what people call pets, is really, I call them animal companions. If we neglect these poor creatures and, you know, that these living organisms and creatures that can't depend on themselves, that need someone, and you chose to be the one and you fail, then you fail as being a nurturing mother. Because a mother is within us. The divine feminine energy is within us, whether you're a man or a woman. Deep in the soul, we have that divine feminine, that divine mother within. So just to each person will be individual. It will be an individual situation for each one of us individually. That's the beauty of uniqueness. That's why it's best if you check your birth chart so that you know more how it affects you particularly. It would affect us all very differently. Nevertheless, it still affects. We all have all of the 12 zodiacs in the chart, within our chart. Some of them have stronger energies, some of us don't, but we all have all of them. So that's where it comes, like we are one. We're all interconnected somehow. So everything, what affects you affects me, what affects me affects you. As species here on this plain earth, everything coexists together in one living organism. It all affects us, whether we want to accept that or not. And that is something that the Cancer mother energy understands or understands deeply, very well. So because this is a new moon, we don't want to get depressed and just negative, because if we lower our vibrational frequencies and fall into a depression or just a downer, how it can happen to a moon sign of Cancer. That's why they say that they are moody, but there's nothing wrong with moody. Moody means that you are in sync with the moon. So I understand that energy. Getting clear on, are we feeling happy where we're at? Are we feeling happy who we're with? Are we feeling happy with what we do in life? Are we feeling happy as a mother figure? Are we feeling happy as a caregiver? And so on, whatever relates, whatever resonates. Plant your intentions this new moon in Cancer on this beautiful night. And put your intentions on how to get yourself out of the situation the importance it is that you feel good with thyself first and foremost. Because we can never help others, we can never love others, we can never nurture and protect others if we ourselves don't feel good, safe, secure, and confident in ourselves and in our lives. So plant that intention, whether it's building the relationship with your mother or with your children or all karmas that needs clearing or whatever resonates. The home, in my case, the home is a time to move on somewhere else. It's a time to get away from certain people that don't make you feel safe, comfort, secure. This relates all to the home, the safety of the home, the security of the home, the comfort of family, the nurturing love of the mother. So things you can do for this day, prepare yourself prior to the moon magic, have a candle for divine feminine, divine masculine energies, and then the center magical candle that can be blue, light blue, would be the best for Cancer energy, which is water sensitive. Of course, this is the huge day to do bay leaf manifestation, so you can have 3 bay leaves prepared and write 3 specific intentions that are realistic and that you have conviction in, and write them there, get them ready, prepare yourself, cleanse yourself. Always it's important to cleanse yourself physically and meditate and make sure that you enter the new moon magic already released. So if you know that you have junk to release prior to the new moon, do it a day or two before to make sure that you're manifesting good things. You want to be feeling in a really good and envisioning these things you want with conviction at the moment of moon magic, not doing some shadow work. But if that happens, which it can happen, what you can do is just flip the whole intention and focus on, you know, my intention is to once and for all release all that does not serve me, all blockages in my way, and then you utilize magic to your benefit. Now you can flip it around and use it into your favor very easily. It's all intentions and knowing how to play around with it once you're good at it. If you're not into magic, then good things that you can do that are great, that I love, that I do too, is bath rituals. You can make a bath ritual be magical, or you can just simply relax. But doing a hot bath ritual with oils and flowers such as rose, lavender, even jasmine or gardenia, soft, flowery, loving energies that are calming down to relax and to nurture, and play some beautiful Anahata chakra vibrational frequency of self-love. It's a great day, especially for self-love and self-nurturing. But a hot bath, remember that water is Cancer, is water energy. So to connect with literally with water is very beneficial. So hot water, hot bath rituals, if not taking long showers and put an incense and a blue candle in a corner and just shower away. And if you need to cry or if you need to sing, do it under the streaming water. It's a good time to do hydrotherapy, hot cold water back and forth like I do for the lymphatic system. Another thing that I love doing is deprivation tank, floating on the deprivation tank. If you don't know about that, look it up. It's incredible. And the place I recommend, highly recommend, is called Just Float on Pasadena here in Los Angeles. The best experience. But this floating on the deprivation tanks is great for any moon magic with water signs, because you're already floating for maybe 1 or 2 or 3 hours in the water, in the space, connecting to your higher self. So it's great for manifesting, specifically for new moon, these tank deprivations because you're so relaxed, you're not stressed. Sometimes you can cry and release, but most of the time to focus on new intentions because you're so comfortable and so like floating in the space, you don't feel anything, that it's just easier to create your own reality in the mind prior to this. It's incredible. Also, just swimming alone, whether it's swimming in a lake, swimming in a river, being safe, of course, making sure not to swim in some dam or some dangerous, you know, current river. Please be safe. But even in some pool, just swimming and floating and just being in the water, in hot tubs, just water element itself. It's so, so great. If it's nice and warm and it rains, get a little bit wet. Who cares? Rainwater is cleansing and it's very blessing. Even whatever with the radiation, yes, there's, but we need to stop living so paranoid and enjoy life a little bit better. If your vibrational frequency is high enough, then all of this won't affect you. Did you know that? Epigenetics, check it out. Another thing, drinking water. Most of us, I talk for myself, I don't drink too much water. It's very weird. I am literally like some reptilian. But I drink a lot of coconut water all day long, like coconut water. Maybe it's because I'm an islander and I grew up and was raised in the islands drinking coconut on the beach. And I just love coconut. I feel like it hydrates me. I do drink water, but not as much as normal people do. And I feel great. I feel fine. I only drink water when I'm thirsty. But maybe this day is a day that I can dedicate to water and maybe drink more water than I normally do. So, you know, nurture myself with that water and be grateful for the water in my life as well. Anything that is self-nurturing or nurturing others, something that makes you feel good. Remember that this new moon is about how you feel. If you're all alone in your life, if you have nobody in your life, then you have yourself. And that is enough. So you take the day to nurture yourself, go out for a massage, for acupuncture, some just yoga, something fun, something that you enjoy that nurtures yourself, a pedicure or a manicure, do your hair, get your hair done or makeup done or get a massage. That's my favorite, a massage. Something that you feel nurtured. Whether you're a man or a woman, self-nurturing and the energy of the mother cancer we have within us.